I've been advised by a hair expert that taking minoxidil spray can prevent further hair loss. Can you take a combination of minoxidil with PRP treatment? Are there risks involved? Regards.
Thank you for your question. You submitted a question with a photo, but in the text of your question, you are describing a situation where you went to a, in quotes, hair expert who recommended that you use a particular proprietary spray to prevent further hair loss. And you want to know if what the risks of this spray is and whether it can be used in combination with PRP. Well, I can certainly give you some guidance. This is a type of question we deal with every day in our practice. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers. This is a system we developed for treating people with male and female pattern hair loss non-surgically using, amongst other things, a system using PRP. So I'm going to discuss that in further detail. But I want to help you first understand some of the challenges that we have in managing genetic pattern loss. So when you think of the world of hair loss, we're dealing essentially with 95% being genetic, referred to as androgenetic alopecia. So when we talk about this, it is what you generally see as male or female pattern hair loss. And the challenge is that we have a certain limited number of tools to try to interfere with what is literally predetermined in your DNA. So let's talk about the spray that you want to use. First of all, the spray is similar to many other proprietary sprays where they all have one common ingredient, which is minoxidil. And I can comment mostly on minoxidil because in this country, we have two drugs for male pattern hair loss. We have minoxidil and we have finasteride. Now, in my experience, what minoxidil does, and again, you were advised that this topical will prevent further hair loss. Well, whether it's minoxidil or finasteride, it doesn't necessarily prevent, in my experience. It's been more of something that slows it down. Pharmacologically speaking, minoxidil was originally a blood pressure medication with an interesting side effect of the stimulation of hair growth. So it's my observation that as long as you are applying minoxidil, you will stimulate some hair growth and you will prolong the growth cycle of thinning hairs. But you will not do this indefinitely. We have seen many people religiously or with great discipline use minoxidil every day, once or twice a day, and they'll still lose hair. They may have slowed it down to a degree, but they still progress. So I want that at least to be clear, is that the topical application may have some benefit, but it's not going to be something that we're going to work indefinitely. Now, to finish the thought about pharmacologic interventions, we have to then talk about finasteride. Finasteride is a drug. It's a drug that you take orally. It's given in a dosage of 1 milligram once a day, and it's a drug that inhibits the formation of something called dihydrotestosterone, commonly referred to as DHT. DHT-sensitive hair will progressively thin, which means that if you reduce DHT, you will slow down that progression. Again, it's not a cure, but it does slow down progression. In my opinion, in the right candidate, a finasteride will actually work more effectively than minoxidil if you were given a choice between the two. Very often people use both. Now, that being said, can PRP be used? Well, understand what does PRP do? PRP is finally being recognized more in the dermatologic literature as actually having a legitimate effect on hair growth. And with great skepticism, eventually people have started to learn that there is actually remarkable benefits to PRP. And even though there's thousands of articles about PRP, there's a lot of resistance to physicians, at least in this country, to really embrace it. What PRP is able to do is stimulate growth, but the question is, how long can that growth be stimulated? So what we do in our practice and what where we've taken PRP is we appear to have taken it to a different level. When we were first doing, we were doing a lot of hair transplants more than 7 years ago, and we wanted to see improvement in the outcome in terms of the graft survival and the wound healing of the donor area, we introduced this material called extracellular matrix, which was a wound healing material that literally amplified the stem cell wound healing capabilities of your own body. So incisions would heal better, the grafts would heal better, but a nice side effect was that thinning hair got thicker. So we started to work on a system to see if we can use this side effect in a way that can be a primary treatment and actually avoid hair transplant in the right candidate. And so eventually, with a lot of time and a lot of challenges and a lot of obstacles, we figured out a system, and we called that hair regeneration, and we developed a company, TrichoStem Hair Regeneration. So where PRP fits in this is that I explained to our patients, with the drugs, if you're using minoxidil, you can stay on the minoxidil. Because when you abruptly stop minoxidil, it's not uncommon for patients to have a lot of hair shedding, which can certainly be very distressing. On top of that, if you are able to tolerate, which most people can, finasteride, then you've got something that's slowing down or the progression and is reducing the toxic effects of DHT on the hair. But there's no stimulatory effect that is going to be the same as PRP. And so with Acellular Matrix and our algorithm, hair regeneration, we've been able to stimulate regrowth of hair. We've been able to prolong the growth cycle as well as stimulate the shed of thinning hairs and the growth of thicker hairs. Interestingly, our treatment has been sustainable with one injection for more than 5 years for the overwhelming majority of our patients. Every patient is still an individual, so we can't generalize 100%, but 99% is pretty much consistent for both men and women. We always work on every individual, and there are people who I feel benefit from a second injection from a different perspective. But again, we have done something that works very well if independently of the drugs or in synergy with the drugs. The problem we have is that a lot of people are afraid to take some of these drugs, and so the treatment alone has been very, very successful. But I look at it this way. We had drugs and we had surgery, and we had nothing in between. So hair regeneration has become a category that really has created a new category for the treatment of hair loss. It doesn't mean that the other categories are now obsolete, but there is basically another tool for us to use. So I think that certainly you can consider using a combination of a topical and PRP. The only issue I think with PRP that I have seen is, in contrast to how we've been able to use PRP in other areas, whether we use it for fine lines and wrinkles or under eye dark circles or for skin complexion and acne scars, when it comes to hair, PRP really has to be done very consistently because the effect seems to wear off pretty quickly alone. In hair regeneration, where we've created this algorithm using PRP with acellular matrix, we're able to do one injection and then maybe 15 to 18 months later, a second injection. but with that, we've been getting 5 years of sustainable growth. As I explained to our patients, we can't change your DNA, we can't change your genetics, but what we are trying to do is work hard to try to redirect the instructions to your hair to maximize the or prolong the lifespan and the growth cycles. So as far as the safety of any topical is concerned, usually when these topicals are applied, if they don't cause irritation to the scalp, they're generally well tolerated. I have an issue with proprietary blends. I think ultimately without minoxidil, most of these blends would not be effective, but that's certainly an issue that can be explored separately. But I think that using PRP in combination is perfectly acceptable, but just a matter of understanding what the limits are and what's the horizon when you undergo these treatments. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.